Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fourth part of my Flyhawk Models 1/700 scale HMS Prince of Wales build. This is the much-awaited edition when we finally get to paint this beautiful kit. But before we do that, please do leave a like on the video if you have enjoyed the series so far, and do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, don't forget to click the bell icon to stay updated with all future posts. Right then, with that out of the way, let's get on with the build. So last time, we had black base the entire ship. Now I take a super thin masking tape and mask off the waterline. I always keep some really thin masking tape handy. It really helps in masking small detail accurately, particularly when it comes to aircraft canopies. In case you don't have thin masking tape, you can simply cut strips off from regular tape. I had two choices for the hull red, this enamel from Tamiya and this one from Mr. Color. I settled for Mr. Color as it appeared to be a little more red than the Tamiya one. Once the hull red was dry, I masked it off. Here is the selection of paints I will be using for this kit. 3 greys, 1 dark grey and 1 green. I start with Mr. Color 338, light grey. I did not like the way the light grey was looking, so I gave up on that and shifted to 335 medium sea grey. This I felt looked much better, and I decided to use this as the base for the ship. I would add the camouflage and the highlights on this base color. The next color to go on is Mr. Color 305 Gray. I must point out that I had the choice between airbrushing or hand painting the camouflage pattern. I chose to airbrush it only because I thought there were many fragile photo etch and plastic pieces on the kit, and this would be the safest approach. In hindsight, I should have hand painted the camouflage scheme. Though there is nothing wrong as such with the way the airbrush scheme looks, it is not historically correct. Also, in this scale, hand painting sharp edges would have been better. So in the end, while I was happy with the paint job, there was this nagging feeling in the back of my mind that sharper edges would have been better. I never considered masking the kit, as using tape or putty would surely have damaged several parts. Mr. Color 116 RLM Black Grey goes on next. Thank you. Now Mr. Color 70 Dark Green. I went back over the camouflage scheme a couple of times with the grays to clean up any overspray. Lastly, I add some white. I had to go back to the grays once again after the white as it needed some serious cleaning up. The guns needed some masking, which I did with tissues dipped in water. Once the paint was dry, I removed all masking. The kit was now given a coat of gloss varnish. As I had said earlier, I did not glue on some parts of the kit, like the main and secondary guns. I now remove these so I can glue on the wooden deck. One note about this blue Vox deck. It must be one of the best fitting aftermarket parts I have ever used. Despite the fact that the ship's deck is full of tiny bits and bobs, each cut of the wooden deck fit in place like a glove. I was thinking it would take me the better part of the day to glue this in place. It took only a few minutes. Oh, and I keep saying glue in place. Actually, the deck is self-adhesive, so it pretty much glues itself in place. All the remaining bits and bobs are now glued in. The Blue Vox deck came with this chain, which I painted black and then glued in. Really nice. The kit is given another coat of gloss varnish. The kit is almost done. We just have a few finishing touches to add and make an ocean base for the ship. However, that will have to wait till next time. I hope you liked this video. In case you did, please do leave a like and do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Remember to press the bell icon to stay informed about all my posts. Guess that about wraps it up. Thank you for watching. Till next time, take care, good luck, and happy model making.